5 o'clock. The bath filled with clear hot water. 6, 7, 8 o'clock. The dinner dishes manipulated like magic tricks. And in the study, a click. In the metal stand opposite the hearth where a fire now blazed up warmly, a cigar popped out. Half an inch of soft gray ash on it. Smoking. Waiting. 9 o'clock. The beds warmed their hidden circuits, for nights were cool here. 9:05. A voice spoke from the study ceiling. Mrs. McClellan, which poem would you like this evening? The house was silent. The voice said at last, since you express no preference, I shall select the poem at random. Quiet music rose to back the voice. Sarah Teasdale, as I recall, your favorite. There will come soft rains and the smell of the ground, and swallows circling with their shimmering sound, and frogs in the pools singing at night, and wild plum trees in tremulous white. Robins will wear their feathery fire, whistling their whims on a low fence wire, and not one will know of the war, not one will care at last when it is done. Not one would mind, neither bird nor tree, if mankind perished utterly, and spring herself, when she woke at dawn, would scarcely know that we were gone. The fire burned on the stone hearth, and the cigar fell away into a mound of quiet ash.